The views and opinions expressed on this program are those of the participants and do not reflect the views of BronxNet or the program underwriters.
BronxNet. Your voice, your views, your vision.
And good morning, everybody, and welcome to Open, the one and only show that opens up the Bronx and the world to you. I'm your host, the Dr. Bob Lee from 107.5 WBLS, your number one source for R&B. And I got a great show lined up for you today. Coming up on today's show, we'll learn all about the types of foods you should eat to help your mood. If you got those moods swinging back and forth, I got you covered. Plus, the legendary DJ Kool Herc is in the house. He's going to share more about this great work that he's doing in our community and his up-and-coming events. And after that, we'll find out about 31 Days of Hip-Hop aimed to elevate your youth. Yes, indeed. And finally, our Music Monday stage features a young rapper spreading a positive message through music. So stay tuned. All this and more is headed your way because we are now open. Hello, everybody. I'm your host, the Dr. Bob Lee, and you're watching Open, the only live and interactive program that brings the Bronx and New York City straight to your TV set. We got a great show lined up for you today, but first, let's check in with our resident DJ, DJ Vince Bracey in the house. How are you?
Diggity, diggity, Dr. Bob Lee.
On the ones and twos.
Yes.
Can you cut it up?
Sick, a little bit.
Sick.
So what's happening, man? Did you have a nice weekend?
Yes, I did. I had a wonderful weekend. Did, you know, a couple weddings, a couple communions. Took my mom out to lunch. We had a great time.
This is also Eagle Week. I forgot to mention Eagle Week.
They have Eagle Academy
has schools all over the five boroughs,
right.
And they had something that gathered all the parents to get them on the same page as the students. And it's a very, very important thing because, you know, a lot of schools have these parent-teachers meetings, and sometimes parents show up, sometimes they don't, and they want to get everybody on the same page for the benefit of that, the success of that child.
Yes, you know. And aside from Eagle Week, it's also the opening of Bronx Week.
Bronx Week starts on the 8th, right?
Yes, I believe
Yeah,
so.
All right.
And I think it's kicking off very soon, so that's going to be in Bronx, and it's going to be covering that, of course.
Yeah, and Mariano Rivera, they're going to do something this morning. They're going to start an avenue, Yankee Stadium. Over by Yankee Stadium, they call it his avenue, Mariano Rivera Avenue.
Congratulations to Mo over there, our all-star closer. I think River Avenue at 161st Street is going to be renamed after him.
Who's celebrating birthdays today?
Birthdays. Today we have a bunch of singers. We have Adele, Chris Brown, Raheem Devon, and Craig David. They're all celebrating a birthday today. And also Brian Williams, the news anchor. Happy birthday to you guys.
Ooh, okay. You leave out anything?
Cinco de Mayo!
Hey! Starts today.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun stuff going on today.
What does it stand for?
Cinco de Mayo, as far as I know, I'm pretty sure it's just a celebration of Mexican heritage and pride. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's a...
There you go. Cinco All right. Vince Bracey, give him a big round of applause, everybody, as we continue. Be sure to tune in throughout the show as we share some upcoming Bronx Week events, okay? We got to take a quick break right here, but when we return, we'll find out all about food and mood. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
A single ember from a wildfire can travel over a mile. That ember can ignite and destroy your home or community. You can't control where that ember will land. Only what happens before it does. Visit fireadapted.org to learn how you can help protect your community from wildfires.
Don't look at me. Your hair's a bit frizzy today.
Aww.
You should pick that up.
Oh, you're such a dork, loser.
Here, let me help you with that.
Oops.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Oh, look. Your crush is looking at you.
Poor you.
They want to help, but don't know how.
See, no one here is going to help you, because no one
Teach your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
All right, our first guest is a holistic health coach and joins us today to share more about how food and mood work together. We welcome Stephanie Levine to the studio. Stephanie, welcome.
Thank you, Bob.
When we first met, I was at one of the spots over on 54th Street.
We're at the Westerly Health Food Store.
Westerly. Right. You want to give a big shout out to the crew
Absolutely.
Over there?
Absolutely. The Westerly is amazing. Michael Toback is the owner.
Yes.
Who's just expanded the store.
Hey, Mike.
Yeah, hey, Mike. And we're just having a fantastic time down there. And I'm the official holistic health coach there.
Beautiful.
Which is fantastic. And that's how we met.
Now, how did you get started? I know you used to work for Island Records in the past. We used to go around and collect records, and you were there.
Right, right. Well, you know, especially Island Records, lifestyle was really important. Mm-hmm. Island, Mango, and all the world music artists that we had there as well. And, of course, the Bob Marley estate was always very into health and wellness and vegetarian. And so it's always music, lifestyle, food's always been in my radar. Mm-hmm. So I just decided to delve into that a little bit more as the music industry changed.
Yes.
And I had
in
already,
a big way.
In a big way, I had had a world music label, you know, and everything was changing. So I went back to study and became a holistic health coach.
Oh, okay. So share a little bit about what you do as a holistic health coach.
Well, I'm a holistic health coach and chef as well. So what we do is we examine your lifestyle. You know, talk to you about what your goals are, and it's my job to help you reach those goals. Mm-hmm. So two things we talk about primarily are primary foods and secondary foods. So your primary foods are, you know, what's happening in your relationships, what's happening in your life, what's happening at work. And lots of times people don't look at that. They just look at, what am I eating? Somebody puts them on a diet, and they're not successful because you need to look at the big picture. So a holistic health coach looks at the big picture, not only the foods you eat, but what's happening in your life and your relationships.
Right, mind, body, and spirit all the way.
Yes,
all
exactly.
Right.
That's exactly
And holistic health, explain to people what it is, because you have a company called Tohi.
Tohi Wellness is a company that has coaching programs and cooking programs as well, where we have a 3-month program, a 6-month program. We look and see what your goals are. We devise strategies for ways for you to get there. We do holistic health food store tours. Holistic means the big picture.
Right.
Okay. It means everything. If you can't make the time, the biggest complaint I get is I can't eat that. I have to grab a piece of pizza because I don't have the time. So it's my job to say, well, let's look at your life. Let's see what's happening for you in the morning, in the evening. Where are we going to fit that time into that you'll be
successful?
But
a lot of that stuff causes problems if you're not eating right and sleeping right and you're not doing the right things.
Well, hugely,
Because, you know, when we first started talking, I was telling you a story about this person who had parasites and they wanted me to help them get something, put something together to help them get rid of it. We won't go into the parasitic thing right now.
Right.
You know, but parasites can infiltrate your intestine.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Well, you know, what we eat absolutely affects our mood. Food is a pathway to our neurotransmitters, and the neurotransmitters basically tell our body you can release, you know, these neurotransmitters will release the serotonin, which is a feel-good neurotransmitter. But if you don't have the certain nutrients that are released in your food, it's not going to be released. So if you don't eat breakfast, you're not going to be in a good mood. You're not going to, you're going to be tired. You're going to have anxiety. But if you're going to eat breakfast, you're setting your body up and saying, you know what? Oh yes, here's serotonin, tryptophan, all the things that we need to literally feel good. It is your roadmap. High blood pressure, diabetes. It will lower. You know, if you're eating the right complex carbohydrates, your body will digest that slower. Your blood levels, you know, sugar levels will be, you know, more sustainable, and you won't be peaking up.
So you can bump down the sugar levels in your body if you suffer from diabetes or hypertension. Yeah. Or those things. You can correct that with foods.
Absolutely.
That's the medicine.
It's the medicine. The food is the elixir, and it's proven. Many, many, many studies. Clients of mine, we've reversed diabetes. Diabetes is absolutely curable, depending on the stage you're at. But with food, high blood pressure with food, and your mood with food. So these are it's a huge, important strides to know that food is not just the fast food, you know.
What about somebody like our executive director, Michael Max Nabi, who runs a lot, he exercises a lot? What should he be eating and doing?
Well, he should be eating really well-balanced meals. You want to have your protein. You want to have your complex carbohydrates, not just your white flour, your white rice. You want to have your grains. You want to have your quinoa. You want to have brown rice, black rice. You want to have greens. All your leafy green vegetables, spinach, kale, collard greens, and then you want to have and you want to span the rainbow. If you can have a protein, you know, fish, meat, chicken, but I'm going to preface, your meat should be grass-fed, your poultry should be, you know, hormone-free, antibiotic-free.
Yeah. And this will help with muscle recovery and all of that stuff.
Yeah, and also hydration is huge. So
yes.
You want to drink at least 3 quarts of water a day, at least. Coconut water is a great hydration.
All
you have your water?
Okay. I'll start right now.
Okay. You can start for me. That's going to help your muscle recovery, and he wants lots of protein.
Lots of protein.
Yeah. That's a protein. Who's running?
Okay. Mike runs.
Okay.
All right. So walk us through a day of meals, you know, briefly. Give me breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Sure. Well, you know, it would be great. I'm going to give you a little twist on it.
Okay.
So, for instance, what I do, because I'm more vegetarian and vegan, okay, people say, what are you eating? What, you know, how do I do that? Reason being, so I literally eat a little differently. So I have miso soup and tofu and some seaweed.
You eat more macrobiotically?
I eat more macrobiotically. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Macrobiotically and vegan. It's a mix, and I actually incorporate, even if you're eating meat or fish or chicken, I'm still showing you a macrobiotic type of way to eat, which is local, sustainable, seasonably.
Yeah.
So in other words,
we're
going to eat, you know, eating a lot of grains, and we're not going to be eating, I'm not eating butternut squash necessarily in the summer. You know, I'm going to be eating more summer vegetables and summer fruits.
And briefly, what do we stay away from?
We stay away from everything white. Okay? I mean, that's, you know, if it's white, you don't really need to eat it. You should only eat meat maybe.
That's your rice, your potatoes,
your pizza, your bread, your white flour, your white rice. It's stripped of nutrients. You want to stay with complex carbs, brown, you know, things that are brown and colored. Anything
and
colored.
Make
span
you
the
happy.
Rainbow. Very happy. Happy and healthy.
There you go. Where can people find you for more information?
Because
we can spend a whole day on this.
We can. And eat well at the same time.
Yes.
I'm Thursday evenings, I'm at the Westerly Health Food Store, which is on 55th and 8th Avenue.
Uh-huh.
My website is tohiwellness.org. Mm-hmm. People can find me there. And I think those are the best places.
So, Mike, I'm coming down. I'm coming down with a sack.
You're going to come down with a sack?
Yeah,
I told him we're coming down. Tell him we need
goods.
Website? It's www.tohiwellness.org, and it's tohiwellness@gmail.com.
And that's T-O-H-I,
that's
wellness.
Correct. That's correct.
@gmail.
Yes, great.
Thank you so much. Give a big round of applause, everybody. Stephanie Levine, holistic health coach, Tohi Wellness. Yes, indeed. You got to come back and share more with us. Okay?
I would love to.
We're going to put you on
Beautiful.
The payroll.
Only kidding,
Mike. We've got to take a quick break right here. But coming up next, we'll sit down with hip hop pioneer Kool Herc in the house. Hey, give him a big round. Let him hear you. Let him feel you. Coming up next.
A new pet is a rewarding experience. And Shelter Pets make super pets. Your new best friend will steal your heart, bring you happiness, and enrich your life for years to come. You can make a difference in the life of an animal. Adopt and bring home a Shelter Pet today. To find out more, visit the shelterpetproject.org.
So, I got this new family, and I don't know what it is about this one, but she can't seem to put down that toy. Oh, and she even talks to it. Who's she talking to? Her mom? She talks to her mom a lot.
Brush, brushy, brush, brushy, brush, brush, brush.
Live with a human for a while, and you get to know it.
Get rid of phlegm and everything.
I know, she does strange tricks for no treats. But the one thing I will never for the life of me know is how she gets so tiny and inside that box. Natalie, how do you get so tiny?
Hey, welcome back, everybody. We got DJ Vince Bracey on the ones and twos cutting it up in the background. Can you hear?
Yes.
He got the mini system, though, going on.
I know that's
He don't have the big Macintosh Blueface amplifier and voice of the theater speakers.
With a D over there, with a dynamite soundtrack.
Our next guest has made his mark in the hip-hop world and joins us today to share all about his great work and upcoming celebration. We welcome Kool Herc, DJ Kool Herc, and song... Well, you can introduce my brother here.
Oh, this is Songless, up-and-coming act, homegrown from the Bronx.
Song list in the house. Here we go. How you
Look
doing,
out man? For him.
You got the crew in the back. You hear him? Let me hear you.
Hello.
We welcome you to the show, man. You've been doing a lot of stuff in our community.
Yes.
You know, you are down as a person who started a lot of this stuff in this game. Yes. Tell us about
beginning.
It.
Right, you know, originally I'm from Jamaica, Kingston, Jamaica.
Yeah, man, boom.
Trenton Rock and Upper Yacht Street, Kingston Boy and all that stuff.
Yeah.
1967, came to this country, you know, Better Life family, and we landed in the Bronx.
Uh-huh.
You know, 611 East 178th Street. Don't forget that address.
That's right.
Between Hughes and Arthur Avenue.
That address is very important. Is that the place we're going to build the building?
No, that's the first, I call it, the first boom coming from Jamaica.
Yeah.
From BOAC, British Overland Airline.
I know that's right.
Yeah, and 118, my old alma mater.
Yeah. So how did you get involved in music?
Because
in Jamaica,
music.
They got the biggest sound systems
yes,
out there.
Yes, indeed. I saw that coming up. My father's a mechanic. He worked on Keith Campbell. He worked on Kingston Wharf Garage at Harbor Street. And he was a foreman. Uh-huh. And a lot of music was coming off the ship. You know, I remember when Ben Crosby, White Christmas came.
Oh.
We know the whole thing.
Yeah.
Jim Reese, Della Reese, and Ella Fitzgerald, Nina Simone, Louis Armstrong. He was letting me know that, you know, that's a good bounce. That's a good
Your
bounce.
Your father was into all of that stuff?
Yes, he loved music. He's like a kind of Kingston boy.
Yeah. But, so you used
a Gaga.
You used to take his, a Gaga.
Yeah, his name is Gaga, call him Gaga.
Yeah, so you used to take his music and...
Schema.
Did you have, what turntables did you have back then?
I was in Gerard's.
Gerard's automatic joints.
Yeah. And after a while, we got the non-belt one, the other one, but we could manually move.
Right.
Then from there, I'm going downtown to Harvey's Equipment Store and other places. Got Thorns turntable. And
the Thorns. I remember the Thorns.
The
belt-driven turntables.
Yeah, it was top of the line, too. But when then come the 1100A. Technique. That's what I jumped
before
on.
The 1200s.
Yes, that's the main thing. I don't care what they put out, they can't beat that 1100A.
Yeah, you can take a spool of thread, take all the thread off, and put it on the spindle, and put a record on top of it, like a little, got to put something like a piece of pen, and turn the needle upside down and play a record backwards.
It worked.
On the 1100.
It worked. I still have them. A dinosaur, but I still have them. Good job.
So you used to play with the Voice of the Theaters?
Yes, I was going downtown to, I saw the Voice of the Theater in the Apollo Theater when they had them. And then went to AST. That's where the big boys go.
Right.
I was building my system up for a DJ from the Bahamas called The Amazing Birth.
Ooh.
He was going to Fordham and had the grant money to buy GLI.
You think
GLI
that's where they got the name of that speaker from? Birth?
I don't know.
Amazing Birth?
That was his name.
The Big Birthers.
He had the GLI system that I love.
Yeah.
The four folded horns, two Voice of the Theaters on the side, two Macintosh 2200, and some Thorn turntables,
a
five-band equalizer JVC, and a reverb.
Wow. But wait a minute now.
Surrounded with music. It don't hurt your ear to feel it.
Yeah, you can feel it.
Yes.
So you had the amplifiers of Blue Face, Big Macs?
Yes. Yeah, the Blue.
You still have those?
Yes, I still do.
You have all your original equipment from back in the day?
I didn't smoke it up. People put some money in that. I couldn't do that.
Oh, yeah?
No, I didn't stay right there. And the clergy came to my house and said, what's going on with them? Everything is still downstairs, Miss Campbell. Because she calls it Black Hawk down.
So before we get into... my man here, tell us one thing. How did you get started in hip-hop? Because you are named as a person,
I loved
founder,
it. I was,
the godfather.
I was athletically inclined. I come from Jamaica. I was a cyclist. I liked riding my bicycle. Mm. My legs was developed, and I was playing very aggressive basketball. A lot of names started to stick on me. I didn't like it, so I stuck with Herc. It was Hercules.
Yeah.
I didn't like it, so I said, what's the short name for Hercules? They said, Herc. And back home, back in the neighborhood, I had the name Cool, so I put the two names together.
Cool.
When I first came to this country, they were trying to call me Clyde, but my name is not Clyde, it's Clive.
So the
biggest person then was Clyde Ward Fraser.
So I said, Clyde?
I said, yeah, it's Clyde. But after my father started calling me Herc, that was it.
Uh-huh.
You know, so it came about me like my music. I used to buy my records at Cousins. Asked by my record at Rhythm Den, Richard T on Tremont Avenue, Arthur Avenue.
Yeah.
And downstairs record, Nick's, from down 42nd Street, was downstairs. I just like rare music that should be on the radio, that's not on the radio.
Yeah.
That's where you found me at. So my record's the one that's a Cool Herc record.
And you found hip-hop.
Yes, well, I never named it, but people said, go down there to the little gutter rats, go down there. I was like, give me your sneaker wearing, your jean wearing, come here. But it was respect. It was never no fights. We never don't hang out in front of the building, in the building, or anything. All I heard was, you got it, Herc, you got it. So I was like a big brother over to him. And in the building, we got burnt out, so we got relocated to the Congress Plaza Hotel. We stayed there till we mother find something, 1520. Mrs. Campbell, we found a nice building, brand new, Major Deegan Highway, parallel Cedric Avenue, and we have two bathrooms. Ooh. two bathrooms. So dad no problem when he come home. You know what I'm saying? So, and then the recreation was there for any meeting, any birthday, wedding, $25 to rent it. So my sister's going back to school, working youth court job. And I mean, and
I had one of those.
So we, neighborhood youth court. They was to ask me to protect them to go take the check.
Yeah, yeah.
So I had to have a squad of people around me. But it started out, she wanted to give a party back to school.
Uh-huh.
And I was heavy into my graffiti, I left my music. I party at a place called The Puzzle on River Avenue, 167th. Mm-hmm. Then the tunnel on the 161st and the Congress Pass Hotel, which I had to come back to the party after I moved out of there. And then it started to spread. Because the gangs was tearing up the parties and stuff.
Yeah.
And this was convenient. Two bathrooms, recreation room, kitchen. I played my music from the room, observed the floor.
I know. I was DJing at one party. It was Co-op City. And gangs came in there and tore up the party. They left me alone. I had to turn tables and everything, but tore up everything around
it. They asked me to be division leader. I wasn't with it. You know what I'm saying? I had my friends.
Was it the Black Spades back then was one of the
Black
games.
Yeah, Black Spades. I had some friends that were chief and a division leader. They asked me, and I didn't need it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I wasn't putting them down, but after you leave from a bunch of people by yourself, where the gang at? By yourself.
How has hip-hop changed?
It changed a whole lot. First of all, it provided a payroll. You know, give the kids another way to get out of the neighborhood besides jumping, besides running fast, and selling drugs. You can music. I call it Black Gold Ghetto Steam. That's still gushing.
And you're still DJing today.
And nothing changed. I still my wax. Wax is, I'm the John Henry of it. I still pay my wax.
Yeah.
Quality, high fidelity. And I'm with, you know, new stuff too. I don't stand in progress. You know, I always have, I call it an up and coming rookie to be involved and share it.
And you have a big event coming up. Tell us about it.
Yes, it's at the Andrew Freeman Home, 1125, the Grand Concourse. Between 166, 165th, across the street from the
Bronx. You're DJing at the mansion, basically.
At the mansion. Well, hip hop have a birthplace, but now we have a home.
Yeah.
And we're not at the bottom now, we're in the Grand Concourse. And anything six blocks away from Yankee Stadium is business.
There you go. When is this party coming up?
It's going to be May 10th, the day before Mother's Day.
Yes.
And this was for March 1st. It was
a
nice one.
Shoot, that's coming up.
Yeah, and you on the
this
card.
This weekend, yeah.
On the card. And we got, you know, Ralph McDaniel. We got Melly Mel. We got Tress and Black Sheep.
Yeah.
We got Dana Dane and also Shantae Roxanne.
Yeah.
You know, she's hosting. We've got Jerry Leader.
Uh-huh.
That's going to be in the other room. We've got three rooms. Three
rooms.
And EZLA going to have one of the rooms.
There's a young man sitting next to you coming.
Oh, yeah. I'm looking at my label now. No more CDs added to me.
So what's happening with your label? Introduce this young man
this,
again.
This is homegrown Songless.
Songless is in there. Let him hear you, y'all.
Songless.
Yeah. Songless.
Hello to the hello.
Homegrown.
Definitely.
It's up there with Neo. He's up there with Usher. Somebody gonna make his stamp on the music business.
There you go. You ready for this?
Hello to the hello.
Definitely. Hello to the hello. A quick little something something.
I feel like I finally found
shucks.
My queen. I place no one above you, treat you royally. And I can't stop thinking about you even in my sleep. And I know we were meant to be.
Let him hear you, y'all. Let him hear you.
He's going to debut on the 10th.
There you go.
He's going to have his platform.
He's going to be, gonna be in one of the rooms, huh?
Oh, yeah. We're going to put it down.
We're going to turn that room out.
We're going to put it down.
All right.
And he has some other people with him on the CD that they have to be contacted. Please.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
They're one of the three records I'm feeling right off the bat.
Oh, that's
beautiful. Ready to go. Sure. And there's some more stuff to it now, but these are three to say.
A producer extraordinaire, Helen Greenberg, she has to get you to come in and do some stuff for us, okay? Give Helen Greenberg a big round of applause, everybody. I can't thank her enough. She really puts it together. She knows how to do her thing. She's silent, but she takes care of business.
Also,
action.
Also, Red Alert. It's the DJ.
DJ Red Alert tonight. That's my man. Indeed. I see him all the time over at the
radio station. And Red Fox, that man. Pum Pum Shots.
Yeah, Red Fox.
Reggae, and also Super Mike.
Beautiful.
That's Brad's that's Brad's nephew.
Uh-huh.
God rest his soul, from Grand Groove.
Man.
Who made the record, the label Catch the Beat.
Yeah.
That's his nephew.
Where can we get more information on this? Is there a website or email address?
Right now, the website not there more than, you know, it's in the Bronx, on the Grand Concourse. come check it out or go to the Andrew Freeman website.
You know. Pump some up right here at BronxNet. All right, with Michael, Mike, and Avi, and everybody. Give him a big round of applause, everybody. Hip hop pioneer, DJ Cool Herc is in the house. Yes, show. To the beat, show. Here we go, yo. Just throw your hands high in the air. Wave them around like you just don't care. Like a Ginger Rogers and a Fred Astaire. Let me hear you say, oh yeah.
I big up to Walter, the proprietor over there at Andrew Freeman Home.
Beautiful. You know? All right, we're going to take a short break right here, but when we return, we'll find out about 31 Days of Hip Hop. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.
Thank you, sir. All right.
Let's rock. And don't stop. Keep on.
Vince Bracey's in the house. That's Vince Bracey. Give Vince Bracey a big round of applause, everybody.
All right, give me a spot. You know my motto, safety first.
They could be dangerous. I think we should call animal control.
Animal control?
To be safe.
Don't worry. I got this. It's a new motto.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
I don't know what's happening. Start a new check. What did I do? Okay. Wow. That is so weird.
Hey! Hi!
Oh my gosh.
Hi!
God, I don't even know what to say right now. I'm so nervous.
Gia, you're so big.
Come closer to the camera.
Wait, now you're in my face.
That was so good.
Welcome back, everybody. I'm your host, Dr. Bob Lee. All throughout May, the Queen's Library and Billion Entertainment will be hosting 31 Days of Hip Hop. And joining us to share more about this is artist Shiro H. Am I right?
Stereo H. Yes, indeed.
In stereo, real. How you doing, man?
I'm chilling, man. How you doing today, brother?
Good. You gonna do some stuff for us today?
Yeah, nice to see you again, Bob.
So I see they got Chuck Chill Out on here, DMX Grandmaster, Grand Mixers, and all kinds of stuff. You've been working with them?
Yeah, I've been working with a lot of those guys. We have 30 Days of Hip Hop, okay? And it's gonna be at four different libraries in Queens and all over New York or whatever. And on May 31st, I participate as well as Cool Herc, and it's thrown by Ralph McDaniels and the Billion Entertainment, should I say. And it's going to be great.
So what's the role of Billion Entertainment? They're just putting all this stuff together? They do a lot of stuff.
Yeah, they do a lot of stuff, man. That's my label that I'm on, and we do a lot of great things. We have a foundation called the Billion Foundation, where we go to different schools and keep the music programs actually going, because they really don't exist anymore.
Yeah, they try to cut a lot of that out. A lot of schools lost their funding, because I get a lot of calls too, asking if we can participate and help rebuild what they've lost through the missing of their funding and all that stuff. Okay. So share a little bit about the 31 Days of Hip Hop. Is it 30 or 31?
I believe it's 31.
Yeah.
Days of Hip Hop.
Or 30, they just added another one because it's...
you know what I'm saying? I don't know that part. But it's really about the teens and stuff and having them to have something to go to. And it goes into the aspects of fashion, mm-hmm. business, dancing, everything that has to do with hip hop. You know, it's...
That's so this is how we can use hip hop to help educate our youth too.
Yeah, if they want to, exactly. If they want to go into hip hop or the music industry, and you know, period, this would be great for them. It's like a, you know, it'll be really great. You know.
Yeah. You have something called Red Alert's Revenge.
Yeah, that's my latest single out right now. It has a legendary DJ Red Alert.
You got him on there.
I got him on there. You know, he's a tough guy, man. Yeah, he don't just hop on anything.
No, he don't.
You know what I mean?
So he doesn't.
I got him on there out of the love, and yeah, man. So I'm giving back to the old school artists.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah,
that's
yeah.
basically what I do. You know what I mean? With my
music. That's beautiful. Now you started rapping when?
About 14.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you've been down for a little while, right?
Yeah, professionally about 8 years now.
You got some skills?
Yeah, I got some skills. It took me around the world, you know what I mean? I'm sitting in front of here with you,
Spit 16.
Oh, man, don't put me on the spot. You know what I mean?
If I give you a beat, should I do the beatbox?
Nah, I, you know what I mean? I don't want to rap right now. I just kind of want to just kick it with you, you know what I mean?
No, I hear you. All right, so what's so important about hip-hop right now, from what you can see?
Hip-hop is still the voice of America. It's still the voice of the youth. It's the voice of street people that have nothing, you know. Yeah. That's what hip-hop represents.
And you mentioned still. Fashion and all those things before. Hip-hop incorporates all of that stuff, right?
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, not just here, but all over the world.
Yeah, with the dancing, graffiti, you know, it's still big in other parts of the world. Not so much in America, but in other parts of the world, still big.
And I know it's a different genre, but Pharrell was on with Oprah a few weeks back, and she played a clip for him showing that, you know, they were singing that Happy song in every part of the world, you know.
Wow,
that's
big.
Happy. People were just doing different things. Mm-hmm. And that's the way hip-hop is, too, because I was taking this class, and I was doing my master's program, and this girl had to present a project, and... I think she had to show, I mentioned this before on this show, she had to show that, it was a cultural thing, and she had to show that they were doing hip-hop or this type of music in China.
Mm-hmm.
So she played, she had a boombox, she put the beat on and everything, and the beat was a and then the rapper that came in started rapping in Chinese.
Oh wow!
So that right there, she demonstrated how hip hop has spread all over the world, even in China.
Yeah, definitely. It's going. Mm-hmm. It's worldwide now. It's really not the little. It's not just for the Bronx no more. It's everywhere.
Yeah, they just thought it was a fad back in the day.
It's really not. 30 some years later, we here. You know?
Yeah. So you do a lot of charity work.
Yeah, with the Billion Foundation, like I said, we go to the schools, we hand out free instruments for the music programs.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's how I want to do my music. I want to align it with, like, personal stuff and stuff that means something.
I like that. Giving back, you know.
Yeah.
And not just giving back to give back to get publicity, but giving back from the heart, something that you're really passionate about.
Yeah, I think that's the only way you should do music is with your heart, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. So you have the CD out?
Well, yeah, I have a couple of things on iTunes and stuff like that. They can get old stuff of mine. I was in a group called BDS, Boondock Saints.
All
right. I'm one half of that.
Yeah.
And my latest project is a mixtape called the Philip Pinnell Tapes.
All right.
And that's something that, once again, my music is very personal. So it's a little background story to that, you know.
Look, there you go, look.
There
you go.
That's a friend of mine. He was killed in 1990.
Yeah.
And
so you dedicated a lot of stuff to him.
Yeah, and a lot of the music on the actual mixtape is from the 90s.
Yeah.
So it's really some classic stuff on there. It's not like, okay, I'm trying to be the 90s again. No, it's real actual music from the 90s. So if you enjoy that music, you'll enjoy the mixtape.
Cool. Gotta get Vince some music so that we can play here on the show.
Definitely.
Vince, you ready for that? We're going to lace you up. We're going to lace out your computer. All right. So where do we go next? How do we get your CD, and how do we get in touch or keep in touch with all the things that you're doing?
Well, you can hit me up on Twitter at Hashim Bing. Hashim Bing, Facebook, Stereo H, same thing. And that's basically it. And Dat Piff, that will be where the new mixtape will eventually go.
Can you come back one day and hit our stage, our sound stage?
Oh, yeah. You know, well, I've been here twice before, and you've been a great a supporter of what I've been doing, as well as DJ Red Alert, Ralph McDaniels, you know, my whole team, Billion Entertainment.
Well, we got to continue to back people who are doing some wonderful things in our community, you know, things that are meaningful.
Thank you.
You know, thank you so much. So where can we get your information again?
Oh, that's
get your CD and
Hashim Bing at Facebook, Hashim Bing on Twitter, iTunes. I'm all over there. You can get my stuff there. And I want to say shout out to Natasha Pinnell. Mm-hmm. She's the sister of Philip Pinnell. And, you know, she's been a great supporter in what I've been doing as of late.
All right, Tasha, big shout out to you. Big it up, big it up, big it up. Stereo H, everybody. Give him a big round of applause, everybody. Thank you so much, man, for joining by.
Thank you.
You got to come by and sing a song for us.
Definitely, I definitely will.
16. Hold up a second. We got to take a quick break, but when we come back, it's Music Monday, so stay tuned. We'll be right back. Thank you.
Lemon from Oakwood 2.0 on BronxNet, the show by teens, for teens, and about teens. Catch us every Friday at 4:30 and anytime on the web by going to www.bronxnet.org.
So you heard of the Chewbacca fish?
Yeah.
Chewbacca who?
Well,
you heard of the Chewbacca fish, haven't you?
Yes, I did.
Okay. And could, just so the people at home know, describe it real quick for us.
Describe what?
A fish that flies out of the water, like almost like a rocket. It goes like 12 feet in the air. And then what happens is it comes back down before it hits the water. It like flies into people's neck and like starts biting you in the neck and in the face.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. If it's out there, I'm going to catch it on camera because I've been out here with my camera for years.
You know how the Chewbacca fish works? What happens is it shoots it like rockets out of the water, like 5 feet in the air, and then as it's it jumps, and then what happens, like 5 feet in the air, comes down, like, you know, right before it hits the water, like it like does a psych, and you know, one of these moves and flies into your neck and starts like biting you and stuff.
Nah. They don't have the fish like that out here, do they?
Yeah, it's the Chewbacca fish. That's what
they have it out here in the Bronx.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
And then what happens is right before it comes and hits the water.
Yeah, he died with somebody.
Exactly.
Hi, this is Jeff Fox for 107.5 WBLS. And when I get off the radio, I check out my man, the Dr. Bob Lee. It's open on BronxNet. I never miss it.
NFC, AFC, offensive linemen, defensive tackles, quarterbacks, and cornerbacks are all working with United Way for a million little reasons. The kids of our communities. To ensure their academic success all the way to graduation day. You see, it takes about 12 years to create a graduate, but it takes the same time to create a dropout. And the difference between a kid becoming one or the other could be a professional athlete or it could be you. Studies showed the earlier we get to kids, the better their chances. So become a United Way volunteer reader, tutor, or mentor. And make a difference in the life of a child, for the life of that child.
Give. Advocate.
Volunteer. Live United. Join your favorite NFL players. Take the pledge. Go to unitedway.org.
Here we are. Welcome back, everybody. I'm your host, Dr. Bob Lee. Now it's time for Music Mondays. And then you get that on the... Juanito Jones is in the house, everybody. Give him a big round of applause, everybody. He began his music career about 5 years, when he was 5 years old. I was going to say 5 years ago, but then I was going to go... Wait a minute. Hold up. Wait a minute. And he has performed all around the music of music area of New York City since then. And we welcome him here to our Music Monday stage. Give him a big round of applause, everybody. Juanito's in the house. Hit us off. Hit us off. Hit us off.
Juanito. Knowledge. Power. Enlightenment. Freedom. Classes in session. Who? Juanito. 3, 2, 1. Check. Revolutionary suicide. You thought I was stupid, right? This time I shall do it right. Second chance I do it twice. My mind's complex. I'm scared of depth. You're scared of depth. And indirect messes that I detect. Spitting blood. I cut my neck. Don't sweat. We file taxes. Iraq attacking. It never happened. They shot Osama. You were clapping and I was laughing. You confused? Believe the news? Didn't even know what to do? Police department saw Sean Bell. They decided to shoot. Boom. Had generations doom, it's time to grab a broom to sweep up all the racism and chess. I'm making moves, don't move, because if you do, they'll separate you from my group. The enlightened ones making chicken broth, you want a sip of our soup? Why does this happen when I think and we're reacting? My mind is set, knowledge is what I'm grasping. Revolutionary suicide, revolutionary suicide. I said, why does this happen when I think and we're reacting? My mind is set. Knowledge is what I'm grasping. Revolutionary suicide. Revolutionary suicide. Check. Please shoot me, don't shoot me. Damn, you got me hesitant. That president doubt this nation's intelligence. But I'm intelligent, excellent through my excellence. You prefer that I'm preferring a certain preference. Present gifts. Girls are getting septum rings. I was disgusted, it was you in which I trusted. I'm talking about America, no more need for discussion. Corruption, stereotypical people, all of our Muslims. The beers on trillions of diamonds, ain't that something? I said, I'm not a teacher nor a preacher, simply a wise man. You're falling to your empty soul, grab my wise hands. My mind is so enlightened, man, I have a wise plan. Jose just engineered this track, listen to this wide pan. Why does this happen when I think and we're reacting? My mind is set. Knowledge is what I'm grasping. Revolutionary suicide. Revolutionary suicide. I said. Why does this happen when I think and we're reacting? My mind is set. Knowledge is what I'm grasping. Revolutionary suicide. Revolutionary suicide. Juanito.
You don't like the way I dance? Give him a big round of applause. Give him a big round of applause, everybody. Let him hear you. Juanito Jones in the house. Yeah. Now, wait a minute. You got your own cheering section here. You want to name some of the people who are here? Shout them out.
We got my mentor, my father, Shazam. Uh-huh. So everybody give him a round of applause.
Yeah, all right. He's the biggest cheerleader too, huh?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
I want all the beautiful women.
You got. You see, Dad's jumping in. Exactly. Oh, we should get Dad to come on in here.
Yeah, we should.
Cool, Dad, stand here with us.
Sure, Bob.
Yeah. Now, how did you get started in this music business?
I started when I was 5 years old. I just picked up a pen and paper and just started writing, music ever since I was five, and I was just inspired through life. I really got deep into enlightenment and consciousness, and I just started really writing positive messages throughout my music.
Yeah, they said you want to be positive. Your whole rap is positive. You want to just show the world that you want to present them with this positive message.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, I understand you're an actor also.
Yes, I am an actor.
Yeah,
that is,
all right.
That's correct. I am an
you
actor.
You got your SAG card and all that
yeah,
stuff?
Yeah, I do. Actually, I got started as acting. I love the arts as well as I love music, as anybody would. But I went to acting classes, them for about 2 years, and from there, I shot my first independent film, which was called Miguel, and it aired at the Five Films Festival.
Oh, cool.
Directed by Bob Giraldi. He actually directed Thriller and a couple videos with Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
But long story short, it actually won as one of the best films at the Five Films Festival, and we're actually working on the full whole hour movie that will be on the big screen. Hopefully, we have our fingers crossed.
That's
and
beautiful.
I've been doing voiceover works on commercials for Adidas. And
So you did a lot
in
5 years.
I've done a lot.
Since 18. You're 18 years old.
19.
Yeah, all right.
19.
So your TV commercials, what are they? You said Adidas?
I did a couple voiceover commercials. I did a voiceover commercial for Adidas, Adi Zero Sonic, one of their new sneakers that came out. I did a commercial for Red Lobster, a voiceover, and I did a voiceover for Nike. So I've been around.
There you go. Yeah, you've been around. Yeah. All right. Yeah. Let me see. Which one do you remember the most? Which commercial?
I remember the Adi Zero Sonic commercial the most.
How's it go?
It starts off, you know, a guy was tying his Adidas and he's running, and I go, why do I wear lightweight Adi Zero Sonic? I wear them because I want to be faster. And it keeps going from there.
Yeah.
So, you know, it was pretty cool.
That's beautiful. Yes. But back into your music.
Yes.
How does your music resonate with what's happening today?
I always love staying current. All the time. A lot of people, I call myself a conscious rap artist only because of what I speak about. I don't really stick to one thing. I like, you know, being diverse and just really talking about things that people really don't want to listen to, but it should be heard. You know, because a lot of people just don't look at the fact of the reality of things that's going on.
Now, coming along, you got to have some role models, some people that you've looked up to in the past. Yeah. Who are those people?
Artist-wise or just people?
Artist-wise.
You
can throw in the people, too.
Yeah,
your father.
Yeah, sure. My father, Shazam. Also, I look up to a lot of artists, a lot of old-school artists and new people, like Common, Nas. Yeah. I look up to Kendrick Lamar, one of my top favorite rappers at the moment. But a lot of all these artists
Who's
have
Gazoos?
In common. Zeus, he's from Rack City Studios. He's one of the heads over there. But I look, all these artists have consciousness involved, and they're all conscious rap artists.
They're not just spitting a bunch of
No, they're not. They're actually speaking about something, and it's a positive message, which I try to get across.
How important is that today?
I think it's very important because the generation, you know, me being young and 19, a lot of younger kids look up to me and a lot of kids my age. And knowing that right now what's going on in the world isn't so positive, having me come out and speaking about a positive message really influences a lot of kids and makes them want to change their life. So
but what do you tell those people that want to follow in your footsteps?
I definitely tell people that, you know, if you want to get there, if you all that time just keep going, never stop grinding. You know, it's all about pursuing your career. And if I can do it, I tell people, if I can do it, why can't you do it?
That's what I'm talking about. Now, where can we get your music? Where can we follow you?
You can find my latest album is on hotnewhiphop.com. Search up Class Is In Session. I'll also be putting it up on iTunes very, very soon. You can follow me on Twitter at JuanitoJones_. And I'll be making a website very soon called www.JuanitoJones.me. But it's in the making.
You got to give me a high five. You got to jump. Ready?
All right, Here we go.
Give him a big round of applause, everybody. Juanito Jones in the house. Juanito, you gonna take us home one more?
One more.
All right, let me hit this and you hit that, okay? Unfortunately, that's all the time we have for today's show. I'd like to thank all of our guests for joining us and you, our viewer, for tuning in and checking it all out. If you missed any part of today's show, well, you can tune into the recablecast of Open at 5 and 10 p.m. or watch anytime on the web at bronxnet.org, or you can catch an all-new episode Wednesday at 10 a.m. with my man, Darren Jaime. For all of us here at Bronxnet, have a great and enjoyable day, and always remember this, what you are is God's gift to you, and what you make of yourself is your gift to God, so choose your choice. Let your choice control the chooser. I'll catch you up on 107.5 WBLS tonight after the quiet storm. Right here on 107.5 WBLS and Open Channel 67. Thank you so much. We love you all. Mwah. Peace. Take us home.
Juanito. Knowledge. Power. Enlightenment. Check, I said, I'm in illuminated, lost lyricist, and I'm killing it. Riding through my mind, taking you on the illest trip. Lighten up,
I'm enlightened like I'm lightning, duh. A soulful monster empowering what you crying for. It's a war out here. Go and dive into your trenches. Experimenting on experiments, what you expecting. I'll connect the dots to conspiracies, it's all connected. They judge us on complexion, take a look at your reflection. Third eyes reflecting, it's impressive. First impression, who you impressing? What buttons are you pressing? I'm guessing that you pay taxes and listen to classics. It's classic. Social structure of classes, slaves in open caskets. I'm 19, internally I'm 87. Blinking constantly, life is changing every second. Wait a second, eating intelligence, taking seconds. I'm a messenger, messenger, people take a message. I discover light with Benjamin Franklin and thank them. Swam to Christopher Columbus and asked him, what countries were you really passing, missing in action? My body is adapting, I'm crashing to an extraterrestrial planet. I'm the leader and the genius, and my team is in on the biggest secret. Fingers crossed, hoping we keep it. Try and master your life, and I will master mine. Helmet protecting my brain, cause I'm a mastermind. The hand is quicker than the eye, get used to misdirection. You misdirected, cause you were misdirected. Correction, talents that I'm possessing, taking part in possessions. Power is so possessive, devils starting to possess kids. Looking for ancestors that made it to the States, and our brothers and sisters that suffered in the caves. The slaves that rebelled were brave enough to escape. I'm saving hip hop, I was brave enough to grab the cape, Juanito.
Thank you.